Welcome back, civil engineers. I hope my video lectures are efficient enough to clear your basic doubts. You can always reach me through comment section and let me know about the topics I should make a lecture on. So today's topic is about curing of concrete. So first let us define curing in layman terms. Curing can be defined as the process of maintaining moisture inside the body of concrete during the early ages and beyond in order to develop the desired properties in terms of strength and durability. Technically speaking, the rate of extent of moisture loss from concrete is to be maintained in such a way that there should be no interruption in hydration process of Portland cement. However, good curing practice is not genuinely followed in most cases due to lack of sufficient knowledge regarding the importance of curing. So in this video lecture, let us observe what chemical reaction takes place in concrete and why curing acts as a catalyst for gaining significant strength. So let us start. Let's understand the hydration of cement first. Now, as we know, cement is composed of argillaceous and calcareous mixture, that is, it is made up of silica and calcium components. The link for detailed video regarding manufacturing of cement, if required, can be found in the description. So these tricalcium silicate or dicalcium silicate compound, which is present in the cement, when comes in contact with water, forms a gelatinous-like substance which is represented by the formula as shown over here. This extrinsic formation, also known as calcium silicate gel, binds with the aggregate leading to a rock solid mass, making the concrete denser, less porous and also enhancing its physical and mechanical properties. This reaction, which results into calcium silicate gel, is an exothermic reaction, meaning the reaction takes place with the evolution of heat. Various other components from cement such as tricalcium aluminate, tetracalcium aluminoferride also reacts with water to form hydrated components, but out of all reactions, the calcium silicate gel formation is the major contributor for concrete strength. The above discussed reaction keeps on taking place till all the free water present in a concrete matrix is utilized, giving rise to more heat evolution. Now, due to this exothermic reaction, the temperature of concrete core is very high, but the surface temperature of concrete, which is in contact with the atmosphere, is comparatively low. Thus, this will create the temperature gradient with high temperature at core and low temperature at surface. Therefore, the concrete will try to expand at core and contract at surface. The resultant tensile force generated due to this, if exceeds the tensile strength of concrete, cracks will develop. Thus, it is very important to keep a check on temperature gradient of concrete. According to American Concrete Institute 301 specification for structural concrete, the maximum temperature gradient should be limited to around 19 degrees centigrade. Thus, ensuring proper curing of concrete will help us to bring the core temperature down and thereby reducing the temperature gradient. So this is the reason curing of concrete is very important for its durability and strength point of view. However, the number of curing days required for each element can be found out in IS 456-2000 code. So, I hope you have finally understood the importance of curing and next time will make sure to do it genuinely. Please like and share among your friends. Also, please subscribe the channel for more such interesting videos. Thank you for watching. Jai Hind!